friends, welcome to this video on lines and angles. In the previous video, we discussed some axioms and theorems related to lines and angles. In this video, we will solve some questions based on that topic. So let's start. In the given figure, triangle CDE is an equilateral triangle. Then prove that angle ADC is equal to angle CEB. Here, by using the linear pair axiom straight away, we can say that angle ADC plus angle CDE equals 180 degrees. And similarly, angle CED plus angle CEB equals 180 degrees. We pay attention to both the equations, then here the right hand side is equal, so the left hand side will also be equal, that is, angle ADC plus angle CDE will be equal to angle CED plus angle CEB. Now, since we are given that triangle CDE is an equilateral triangle, then all its angles will be equal to each other. Therefore, angle CDE is equal to angle CED. Hence, angle ADC is equal to angle CEB. Let's see the next question. In the given figure, lines PQ and NR are intersecting each other at point O. Angle POM plus angle QON equals 80 degrees and angle POR is 50 degrees. Then find the measure of the angle MON, angle POM and angle QOR. Friends, first of all, note how many lines are there and how many rays. From that, we will come to know how many vertically opposite angles are there and how many linear pair angles. With the help of which we can solve this question. We are given angle POM plus angle QON equal to 80 degrees. Angle POQ is a straight line, that is angle POQ equals 180 degrees. Or we can say that angle POM plus angle MON plus angle QON, which is equal to 180 degrees. We need to find the measure of angle MON by substituting the measure of angle POM plus angle QON. We will find the measure of angle MON. We got angle MON as 100 degrees. Now let's find the measure of angle POM. We are given angle POM plus angle QON to be equal to 80 degrees. If we get to know the measure of angle QON, then we can find the measure of angle POM. Here, lines PQ and RN are intersecting each other. That is, angle POR is equal to angle QON and similarly, angle PON is equal to angle ROQ. We don't have to find anything from angle PON and angle ROQ. But since angle QON is equal to angle POR, angle NOQ will also be 50 degrees because we are given angle POR to be equal to 50 degrees. And now if we substitute the measure of angle QON in this equation, angle POM plus angle QON is equal to 80 degrees, then we can find the measure of angle POM, which will be somewhat like this. We got angle POM to be equal to 30 degrees. And now we have the last angle, angle QOR. Let me give some hint here and hope that you will be able to find its measure yourself. The hint is that angle QOR and angle PON are vertically opposite angles. This is a very simple and straight question. Angle AEC equals 1 by 2 angle BED and angle CED equals 60 degrees. This is given to us. We need to find the measure of angle AEC. Now let's see its solution. We know that angle AEC plus angle CED plus angle BED equals 180 degrees. Here, in place of angle AEC, we can write 1 by 2 angle BED, or in place of angle BED, we can write 2 angle AEC, and we will also write the measure of angle CED. Angle AEC plus 60 plus 2, angle AEC is equal to 180 degrees. Now, by simplifying this, we will find the measure of angle AEC. 3 times angle AEC is equal to 180 minus 60. Angle AEC equals 120 by 3. We obtained angle AEC as 40 degrees. Friends, this question can also be given to you like this, that angle AEC is to angle BED, which is equal to 1 is to 2. And it means that if the ratio of these two angles is 1 is to 2, that is, angle AEC by angle BED, which is equal to 1 by 2, which implies that angle AEC is equal to 1 by 2 of angle BED. So friends, a question can be given in different ways. We don't have to divert our attention from the question and the properties. With this, let's end this video. Today we solved some questions related to the pairs of angles. Thank you.